Okay, just quickly, biceps femoris. The semitendinosus in the bovine doesn't go above the tuberitii. And that's why you can palpate the sacrosciatic ligament up there. Come on down here, we can see the gastrocnemius, a really nice soleus muscle. Basically, all the soleus does is help out the gastrocnemius. It is the primary calf muscle in humans. Okay, let's come over here. Okay, sitting right up against the tibia is the cranial tibial. And it's going to be a flexor of the hock. Now, this muscle sits in the same place as our long digital extensor in the horse, but this is the Peroneus tercius muscle. And so Peroneus tercius is just going to come down here. It's also going to be a flexor of the hock. Deep to it here, we've got two muscles. We have the long digital extensor and the medial digital extensor. And you can see here, you got to trace out their tendons, going to the medial digit, the long here going down and going to both digits. And also, attaching to that long is the short digital extensor. Here we have a nice triangular muscle that just like this in the dog. This is the Peroneus longus. So the medial digital extensor and the Peroneus longus we do not see in the horse, just the cow. And then we have our lateral digital extensor that we can follow its tendon on down. So make sure you always follow tendons out. See where they're going. Okay, deep digital flexor here. As we said, gastrocnemius. Over here we can see, you can trace that superficial digital flexor tendon around to find our superficial digital flexor muscle.
Here's our... clarify. So is this the superficial, or is this still part of the gastroc?
This is superficial.
So okay.
Follow its tendon around. See, remember how in the dog they did that twist?
Mm-hmm.
We do that same little twist so that our superficial digital flexor is now superficial.
Okay.
Yeah. Here's our tibial nerve coming down. We've got some muscular branches. And you see the real nice popliteus muscle here. This is more of our deep digital flexor. This is also a deep digital flexor medial head. Remember, its tendon does not go through the tarsal tunnel, but comes down and joins later on. Let's see, find the arteries. All the proximal arteries are going to be very similar as the horse. We're not going to see that anastomosing of the cranial, the caudal tibial and the saphenous like we did. Here we see cranial tibial coming down, becoming dorsal pedal. It's also going to have a perforated tarsal. And just like the horse continues, primary supply is our dorsal metatarsal artery 3. That we can see running down here. Right about in here, it's going to give off a distal perforating metatarsal artery, continue as the dorsal common digital artery. That's going to anastomose with the plantar common digital artery via the interdigital artery. From that, we're going to have our axial digital artery 3 and 4 coming off to be the primary supply to our digits.